He like trapped. He can't even afford a free car.
Late game speed attack on the Cougar Rams can pay them. What is the everyday buying on the Jay Raymond? I will show you.
Jay Ray, where you just come back from? Yeah, you. No, you wasn't. You was quiet. For too long, goddamn. So, you know, we in here talking shit. Just saying. So? Here you go, being hostile.
But I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna outsmart every single
person. I don't think he's hostile. Oh dang, he took his car back.
We've gathered 50 of Rust's best content creators to make them face off against each other in our new UHC game mode.
I know it's your demeanor. I know you for long enough. Just joshing. You blew his car because he kicked you out. Oops. I tried to like, no way, I can't drive your car. Fuck your car. Boom. You can't drive it either. You gonna come back like, where'd my car go? It got blown up.
On what? But the only monument that doesn't have a leak crate spawn is the lighthouse.
And the nanny. That bitch nasty. Throw the whole bitch away. Yeah, mission failed. Try again next life. How is how's he dealing with that? That's nasty. Throw the whole chick away. Throw the whole lady away. That's nasty too. Throw the whole bitch away. A whole bitch in the trash. No refunds. Don't return her to the streets. She's not for anybody. No. This door in the trash. Well, this door in the trash. Foxy came back. It said you left. But it also said you joined. It didn't say you left, but it said you joined. See? Now it said you left. Oh, Foxy can't perform now.
Now, I'm able to get armor easily from the
But the only issue, as mentioned earlier, is White House is the only monument on this map that doesn't spawn elite crates with guns. While everyone on the map is getting high-tier military weapons, I'm getting melee weapons. So that's why I talked to another good friend of mine who was a playtester for this event. I'm actually going to be living at Lighthouse. What do you think about that?
It's not a bad.
Got it this time, so it's okay.
Where would I be able to get a gun?
There's a dome in the middle where you can buy rifle bodies and stuff.
If rifle went all the way, you could be able to get a SMG body or something, or a rifle body?
Yeah.
Alright, am I, you think I can do this, guys?
Yeah.
So, according to my friend Dad, there are vending machines at the dome in the middle where I can buy rifle and SMG bodies to craft a gun.
I don't even know what weed this is.
Because in 15 minutes, the grid period would end and PvP would be enabled. And I can start with melee weapons. But before I did that, I heard a noise outside of what happened. Someone takes the lighthouse in a boat and my sleeper spot was compromised. There could be a PvP chat down there about to catch me hiding at lighthouse and ruin this earth.
Maybe.
Oh my god, Clyde, thank god it's you, man. I was scared someone was coming up on the boat and I'm like, oh my god, it's gonna be one of those chats, but I'm so glad to hear it's you, man. How you doing? Thank God the person who pulled up the lighthouse.
I think that might be the ice cream cake.
Black has been in many videos of mine, and we even did an interview podcast on his channel, so I was relieved to discover it was him. Yeah, I know. I got a quick run to the dome. I'm about to leave here in a second, but I need to buy something. But yeah, what you doing here, man?
I just wanted to call the mission.
Oh, nice. That's smart. I'm going to be back later. I got to go to the dome real quick. Yep. If I don't see you when I'm back, good luck. Now is the perfect time to leave, but you must go buy a weapon, because I didn't want Black to know when I was going to camp at Lighthouse. The more people that know I'm at Lighthouse could potentially destroy the plan. Black, I'm sorry, I love you, but I really hope you're not there when I get back, because I don't want to kill you, Black. It was a peaceful run to dome, but soon I'd be interrupted yet again. The host of this event was another YouTuber named Tacular, who was streaming this event to 700 viewers on Twitter. One thing about Tacular is he is one of the best PvPers in this game, so it's the perfect opportunity to ask him for advice. Since you're a PvP god, you know, and I need your recommendation. What do you think I should go for here as someone who doesn't PvP?
Your hands.
Okay. Thompson.
Hurry up, old man Dane.
Seriously, your best. I'm going to buy Thompson. Thank you so much, Secular.
No worries, Fancy. Honestly, I think you're probably one of the smarter ones in this event. Now that I think about it, these guys are playing checkers, but you're out here, you're playing chess.
Do you really mean that?
I think you've got a good chance.
Alright. There we go, we've got our SMG body, we're going to make a Thompson with this. Now we go back to Lighthouse. Alright. Sweet. Let's see Black isn't here, or anyone else, Okay, I'll take Mr. Black over and help. Black, are you home? It looks like Mr. Black had disappeared, so we have Lighthouse to ourselves again. But it was minutes away before the grace period ends. The Chad baby appears, we're going to start printing. What if barricades keep spawning? Which could be good, it could alert us if someone's coming through. But one advantage I had of camping at Lighthouse is that there are two wooden barricades blocking the entrances, so players have to destroy it if they want to enter. So if anyone sneaks up to my Lighthouse and I don't realize it, I'm completely safe, because all I have to do is use my ears. If someone starts breaking the barricade to enter the Lighthouse, I know someone is here and it gives me time to hide. Alright, Ice Cream Thompson, Blue, Vanzor. Okay, this might be good. It was the final second of the grace period and PvP was going to be enabled for the entire server. While every content creator went for high tier monuments, built bases that were much cooler than I was the only weirdo living in a tier 1 monument. Alright, PvP is enabled, now we watch people die. My god, look at the chat, people are actually dying. The plan was in full motion.
It's scuffed already.
What a fucking nerd.
Oh my god, my trauma's basically over. I've got one more life.
While the entire circle was fighting each other and losing their lives down the dangerous areas of the map, I was comfortably sitting at Lighthouse with my toes out watching it unfold. It was beautiful. It was perfection. My plan was working. While everyone's out there killing each other, that is how you outplay the chats. What am I doing? What am I doing, dude? But after 12 minutes of camping Lighthouse during the PvP phase, I had my first visitor.
Babe.
I did not want to kill him, okay? But I realized these people are my competitors. I need to do what I have to do to get to the end, right? After that, I realized Lighthouse is slowly consuming me and making me do things I wouldn't normally do. This place was making me go crazy. But what I discovered is when you're eliminated, you can still spectate. And when spectating, you can still interact with items and drop or pick them up from the ground. So I quite literally had an angel over my shoulders protecting me in this tournament. Lost, wait. Do I have an angel speaking to me? Drop something to me if you're listening, Lost. Drop something to me. I can hear in front of my face. Oh my god, he is here.
Sounds about right.
I have a family to feed, alright?
I can't believe you would do this to me.
Listen, man, just Just look away. Just please turn around so this is easy for me, alright? Just please. Get away from me! I now had the blood of two innocent men on my hands. I realized by living in a tier 1 area on the map that people who died and are starting fresh will go to lighthouses, the easiest money bin to get a new start. But every single person who tries to do that runs into Mr. Fancywork. Is it ethical to do this? Not at all. But it does make it easier for the final death match in the dome later in this video. Oh my god. Don't open the fucking door. Stop. Stop doing it. Lost. Stop doing it.
Baby.
Serious. Stop. I also discovered that Lost can also interact with doors, which is absolutely crazy. OT, who's hosting the tournament, probably doesn't even realize this, but it's something that can be severely exploited. Any confirmed that we can know he dropped it. With 30 minutes left before the final deathmatch, I realized I'm severely undergeared. All the other chads with tier 3 weapons and armor are going to destroy me, especially since I'm not good at PvP. Well, that's why another playtester this week gave me some interesting advice. So you are UHC playtester, is that correct?
Yeah, I'm pretty much a pro, what can I say?
So I know how I can survive the PvP stage, but I don't know what I'm going to do when I get in that arena. You know I'm not good at PvP, but you've been in that arena, how can I survive it?
You gotta just put it to the center. You gotta secure that, you gotta get something down.
If I run out to the middle, that's a suicide mission.
Get something down. Get some cover down. Get anything. Just secure that point, because it's only going to end there.
Well, I'm really trusting you. Mm-hmm.
Gotcha, man.
Koala told me the best thing I can do is run for the center and build the base. Everyone will spawn on the outside, and their first instinct will be killing the person that's next to them. But if I can slip out from the crowd and sneak my way to the middle of the arena and build the base, eventually the zone will end up with the having got the middle 90% of the base dead. It's risky, and I have no idea if running to the center right at the beginning will work. That's the best thing I've got to do. We have 60 minutes. But as I was prepping my final move before the arena, a familiar voice joined me again.
What's going on, man?
Oh my god, I'm scared to see that. Listen, I'm a guilty man, okay? I've done a lot of things, Sackler.
I think he before told it to yourself, and I was very confused. What's going on?
See, Lighthouse makes you go crazy.
How is it not just guilty? Because from what I see, you're overwhelmed with guilt. Is that something you're willing to live with for the rest of your life?
Spectacular. Whatever I have to do to bring the W home and represent Team Fancywork, I will do it, okay? There was two people, alright? Two people that spawned near this lighthouse, and I had to put them down, Spectacular. Alright, I know, I had to put them down, but I need to get to the end, Spectacular. Alright, I told you I was going to, you said I was smart, you're hyping me up. This is your fault, you made me kill those guys. You said I was smart.
No, listen,
yeah, okay.
Bigger wings. Like the wing sauce, like, is really, really cool.
Hi, Anthem.
What is he? Alright, this is Cyclone Summer. Yeah. Cyclone Summer. That's our first one.
Maybe.
So there's that. What else we got? I'm gonna put my papers in like, oh man, can't wait, who was it? This is like, oh man. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
I can
you select this interest. We got a gal.
To the people who say anime is trash without even watching it. Who would win? Satan fighting for the sale goods. Goku fighting to save the earth. Those who don't know, those who know.
Sweetheart.
Most fictional humans, random fiction levels. When you find out there's a finished Algin on Hedron, this girl's new. What show is she from? Six digit number. To the people who say anime is trash without you.
Hello there, Rick. How you doing today?
I'm just great, did you tell
us?
Now, what you
want to
do for me?
Turn them down, buddy. If you took a 40 and fuck if you had a 5.
So I'm here today to help you find a buck to give. Where would you like to start?
Mineral or vegetable comes between you and the vehicle in front of you. You are to not stop. Run that thing, that person over. You will deal with what remains. Yes, sir. Of course, I'm like, holy people. So we get in the car. Our day is about to begin. Everything comes. The two limos pull up. These guys come. We see the back of their SUV. It is the most assault rifles I've ever seen in one place outside of like a gun show. Vice President gets into one of them, and we're off. And we're thinking, you know, we're like, okay, so first event is under the Brooklyn Bridge. Like, I'll be talking to you on the east side. 30 minutes. I have his press secretary and her staff in my van. We get to our first stop. Everything's cool. We kind of like, you know, the adrenaline's going. We're just like, oh my God, this is right. This is like, oh, 4 feet, 4 feet. And we're like, okay, like, this is serious. This is great. But then, you know, the event happens when we guys kind of get to hang out in the van, you know, talking. And he does a speech, and we get to the, every, you know, everybody in the motorcade gets to come meet him and shake his hand. He's the super nicest guy you ever wanted to meet. Animal, mineral, or...